I'm very honored to welcome all of you tonight to the study of African-American women's fiction, past and futures. Writing. Oh, so thank you. I got two different titles going on here. Which makes it the perfect time for me to say that I was actually given this introduction. I didn't write it. Put a couple twists in it, but apparently not correcting the title. I'm actually just going to delve right into introducing the speakers, because I think that's who we all came to hear and we want to know more about. And it's a very long introduction I was given, so I'm going to try and rush through this. I added a few adjectives of my own, because I was just so honored to be in the room with these three figures and to be in conversation with them. I just, you know, it's very exciting pour moi. Now, does it make sense for you guys to sit on the stage for half a mo so people can see you as I introduce you, so it's not an abstraction?
We can bring them up as you introduce
them. Oh, okay, then we should have an orchestra, you know, rising up. Professor Foster, if you would. Francis Smith Foster is the Charles Howard Candler Professor Emeritus of English and Women's Studies at Emory University, where she has served as the English Department Chair from 2005 to 2008, as well as the Director of Emory Institute for Women's Studies. Francis, you know it was written for me, because I would never refer to you by the first name, but that's what's written here. Frances earned her bachelor's degree in education from Miami University, an MA from the University of Southern California, and her PhD in British and American literature from the University of California, San Diego. Frances has played leadership roles in the National Women's Studies Association, the Society for the Study of Women Writers, the Collegium for African American Research, the College Language Association, the American Studies Association, the Modern Language Association, and the American Literature Association. Wow, indeed. As a scholar, Frances is best known for having authored three pioneering books, as well as a number of influential edited volumes that fundamentally opened up whole new dimensions for finding, reading, and interpreting African American literatures from its inception. Her first book, Witnessing Slavery, The Development of Antebellum Slave Narratives, published in 1979, is regarded as the work that established Black slave narratives as a genre, thus providing African American literature with a richly complex past, if not origin. In 1993, Frances's second book, written by herself, that's part of the title, Literary Production by African American Women, 1746 to 1892, broke new ground by examining the multiple literary traditions and cultural interventions of African American women writing before the 20th century. Her 2009 study of African American relationships in literature and culture, Till Death or Distance Do Us Part, Love and Marriage in African America, reinvigorated a previously understudied area of African American life. And on reflection, we can see how much this has influenced not simply African American literature and Black studies, but humanities and social sciences as a whole, the importance of looking at everyday practices and understanding them as glorious points of insight into a culture and its history. In addition to appearing on the mastheads of a number of influential journals, Frances is also an editor of the Oxford Companion to African American Literature and the Norton Anthology of African American Literature. Professor Guy-Sheftall. Beverly Guy-Sheftall is the founding director of the Women's Research and Resource Center at Spelman College, where she also serves as the chair of comparative women's studies and is the Anna Julia Cooper Professor of Women's Studies. For many years, she was also a visiting professor here at Emory's Institute for Women's Studies. Entering Spelman College at the rather precocious age of 16, Beverly graduated with honors before earning a master's from Atlanta University and a PhD from Emory's Institute of Liberal Arts. Beverly has published a number of revolutionary texts within African-American and women's studies, including the very first anthology on Black women's literature, Sturdy Black Bridges, Visions of Black Women in Literature, published by Doubleday in 1980, which she co-edited with Roseanne P. Bell and Betty Parker Smith. Her landmark, Words of Fire, an anthology of African-American feminist thought, was released in 1995 and is credited by many contemporary women of color feminist activists and theorists for boldly clearing new ground for Black feminist thought by tearing down old conventions and pushing all of us to think more dynamically, creatively, and courageously. And actually, if you go and look at some of the reviews of the book, you get to see people kind of on the edge of ecstasy as they talk about how incredibly important this book is and what it is now allowing them to do. They're feeling empowered and enabled by it. And then all the big names want to be with Beverly because an anthology she co-edited with Rudolph Bird entitled Traps, African-American Men on Gender and Sexuality appeared in 2001. And I Am Your Sister, Collected and Unpublished Writings of Audre Lorde, was co-edited by Beverly with Rudolph P. Bird of Emory, as we all know, and Janetta B. Cole of Spelman, of course, in 2009. Still Brave, The Evolution of Black Women's Studies, was released in 2010 with Stanley James and none other than Frances Foster Smith. In 2010, she, Smith Foster, I knew I was gonna do that once, excuse me. In 2010, she and Janetta B. Cole went on to co-edit the anthology Who Should Be First? Feminists Speak Out on the 2008 Presidential Campaign. And in 1983, she became founding co-editor of SAGE, a scholarly journal of Black women, which was devoted exclusively to the experiences of women of African descent. Beverly is also the past president of the National Women's Studies Association, and in 2017 was elected to the 237th class of the American Academy of Arts and Sciences. Professor McDaniels, if you would. Now, Pellom is the kind of guy that you love to hate because there ain't nothing he is bad at. And I'll explain why through this introduction. Pellom McDaniels III is the curator of African American collections at the Stuart A. Rose Manuscript Archives and Rare Book Library here at Emory. Pellom studied fine arts at Oregon State University before embarking on an athletic career in the NFL. That included playing for the Philadelphia Eagles, the Kansas City Chiefs, and of course, the Atlanta Falcons. The Falcons.
That's her friend's accent.
Falcons. Retiring from football in 2000, Pellom pursued graduate studies at Emory, earning his master's and a PhD in American Studies. His publications include two books, My Own Harlem in 1998 and So You Want to Be a Pro in 2000, along with the 2004 essay, We're American Too, The Negro Leagues and the Philosophy of Resistance in Baseball and Philosophy, Thinking Outside the Batter's Box, and the 2013 piece, The Prince of Jockeys, The Life of Isaac Burns Murphy. Still active as a painter, in his role as curator for the Rose Library, Pellom spearheaded the exhibit, They Came to Fight, African Americans in the First Great War, along with guiding the library's plans for the Robert Langmuir collection, excuse me, of more than 12,000 photographs depicting African American life from the early 19th century to the mid 20th century. So we have here a rather glorious panel before us. And I would actually like to invite Professor Foster to begin with opening remarks.